Shalom, Israel. Captain OC.
Officer Elida.
Today, we're doing 15 minutes with the captains. Today's topic is a very, very important topic. Today, we're going to deal with the issue of if we have to congregate with a camp. Do I need to be a part of a body of believers? Because amongst Israel, a lot of us have the belief. We come in, we understand we're Israelites. We watch the videos. And some of us, we even go out to the streets and we may teach. We may pass out flyers and material. But what one thing that a lot of us do not do is we do not become a member of a body of believers. Some of us call it a camp, and the Bible calls it a church, and it calls it a camp, whatever you want to call it. But we're going to see, is that biblical or is that man's doctrine and philosophy? Let's go to the book of Leviticus chapter 23 and verse 2. One thing that you'll find out is being part of a congregation or a camp is the only way, listen good, is the only way you can apply certain commandments that are written of in the Bible. When you are not doing those, you are not keeping all the commandments of God. All right, read that for me.
Leviticus chapter 23, verse 2.
Uh-huh.
Speak unto the children of Israel.
Speak unto who?
The children of Israel.
So this message is primarily for those who know they're Israelites. Read.
And say unto them,
uh-huh,
concerning the feasts of the Lord,
uh-huh,
which ye shall proclaim to be holy convocations.
Read.
Even these are my feasts.
So God says these are holy convocations that are set up for the children of Israel to observe. Now let's get, what is the understanding of a convocation? Go to the book of Joel chapter 1 and verse 14. Because a lot of people say, well, I do keep the feast. Me and my family, we come together and we have a feast. Okay, we're going to see, is this just about your personal family or is this about a nation? Understood, nobody's going to get delivered by themselves. He's going to deliver the nation of Israel out of the lands of their captivity. Read that.
The book of Joel chapter 1 verse 14.
Uh-huh.
Sanctify ye a fast.
Sanctify ye a fast. Read.
Call a solemn assembly.
Call a solemn assembly, which is what? A convocation. Read.
Gather the elders.
Gather the elders. Read.
And all the inhabitants of the land into the house of the Lord your God.
This is when you would gather all the people together. Not individuals. He was gathering everybody together. So in order for you to keep these feast days, in order for you to keep the Sabbath, you need to gather yourself together with like-minded believers. Now let's go to the New Testament. That was the law. The law was convocation. I'm not going to go through all the different feast days, but you have tabernacles, you have the Sabbath, you have the Feast of Dedication, you have the Feast of Weeks, you have Pentecost, so on and so forth. All of those are convocations. Those are days that you need to be gathered together with believers. Now let's see, what did Jesus Christ, the Messiah, what was the example he left for us? Read that.
Luke chapter 4 verse 16.
Uh-huh.
And he came to Nazareth, where he had been brought up.
Uh-huh.
And as his custom was.
As his what?
His custom
as
was.
As his custom was, meaning this was his tradition. This is what he did on a daily basis. Read.
He went into the synagogue on the Sabbath day.
He went into the synagogue, which is what you would call today, the church, the building, whatever you want to call it. He went amongst other believers. He did not keep to himself. And did what?
And stood up for to read.
And stood up for to read. Meaning what? He was in the scriptures with other like-minded believers. There's a scripture in Daniel that said, he that understands amongst the people shall instruct many. So especially you brothers and sisters that proclaim to be teachers, your job is to gather the people together, not for you to separate yourselves from other like-minded believers. Go to the book of Acts. Chapter 17 and verse 1. Let's see, what did Paul say? What was the example that Paul left for us? We saw what Christ did. Now we're going to see what did Paul do.
The book of Acts, chapter 17, verse 1.
Uh-huh.
Now when they had passed through Amphipolis and Apollonia,
uh-huh,
they came to Thessalonica, where there was a synagogue of the Jews.
Uh-huh.
And Paul, as his manner was,
what?
Went in unto them, and three Sabbath days reason with them,
uh-huh,
out of the scriptures.
He did what?
Reason with them out of the scriptures.
So, this is another example. Paul followed the same example as Christ, as did the other prophets. They always congregated with other believers, wherever they were at. You can read that example of Paul all over the New Testament. That's why when he was writing, who was he writing to? The church in Galatia, the church in Ephesus, the church. He was writing to a body of believers. Understand that. From there, let's go to the book of Hebrews, chapter 10 and verse 25. All right, so what we're doing is we're showing you, if you proclaim to be an Israelite, it is your duty, it is your responsibility, it is law that you gather yourself together with other believers. Read that.
Hebrews chapter 10, verse 25.
Uh-huh.
Not forsaking the assembling of ourselves.
Doing what?
Not forsaking the assembling of ourselves together.
So the Bible says not to forsake the assembling of ourselves together. Showing you what? That if anybody is telling you, I keep to myself, I don't want to be in sin, because whenever you get around other believers, there's going to be sin going on. That's not scriptural. Where is that at in the Bible? Where did Christ say, I'm not going to go into the synagogue on the Sabbath day because brothers and sisters are going to be in sin? Where did Paul say, I'm not going to go into the synagogue, because you won't find that? That's you leaning into your own understanding. Read that again.
Not forsaking the assembling of ourselves together,
uh-huh,
as the manner of some is.
Read.
But exhorting one another.
Uh-huh.
And so much the more as ye see the day approaching.
Right. If you're understanding what's going on in the earth today, the world is coming to an end all around us. You got Trump about to declare war on Iran. You got brothers and sisters changing their body parts from men to women. The world is coming to an end. The smart thing for you to do is to gather yourself together around like-minded believers. What? So you don't find yourself in the midst of these different sins and the snares and the sins of the world. From there, let's go to the book of Titus, chapter 1 and verse 5. Now I'm going to give you another example, showing you that this was the order that Christ and the Most High set up, that he wanted us to have bodies of believers in different cities or camps. Read that.
Titus chapter 1 verse 5.
Uh-huh.
For this cause left I thee in Crete,
uh-huh,
that thou shouldest set in order the things that are wanting.
Read.
And ordain elders,
uh-huh,
in every city.
And or do what?
Ordain elders in every city.
Now, why would they want to set up elders in every city? Because guess what? The brothers and sisters in these different cities, they needed somebody for counsel. They needed somebody to distribute funds. They needed somewhere where they can learn the Bible and get together and what? Congregate. So they can apply all those laws that are dealing with the holy convocations. If not, you are not truly in the truth. Understand it. How are you going to learn how to love your brother as you love yourself if you're never around like-minded believers? How are you going to do that? How are you going to show charity to yourself if you're never around brothers and sisters? You can't apply all the commandments amongst yourself. Understand that. Go to the book of Sirach, chapter 6 and verse 2. The book of Ecclesiasticus, chapter 6 and verse 2. Now I'm going to show you why people keep to themselves and what happens to them.
The book of Ecclesiasticus, or Sirach, chapter 6, verse 2.
Uh-huh.
Extol not thyself in the counsel of thine own heart.
That's what we see a lot of. One thing that's very, very popular amongst individualites, all right, those that keep to themselves, is they have a lot of doctrines and a lot of beliefs that don't line up with the Bible. Read.
That thy soul be not torn in pieces,
uh-huh,
as a bull straying alone.
As a what?
As a bull straying alone.
Understand, when you're by yourself, you are vulnerable to whatever comes to your mind. You will never have somebody to correct you. Go, hey, bro, what you said today, what you thought, that wasn't in line with the scriptures. But if you're always to yourself, who's going to give you that? Nobody. So you're going to always go with whatever comes to your heart and whatever comes to your mind. And the Bible says to do the exact opposite of that. From there, go to the book of Proverbs, chapter 18 and verse 1. The book of Proverbs, chapter 18 and verse 1. We're going to show you another side effect of being alone and being to yourself. Read that.
Proverbs, chapter 18, verse 1.
Uh-huh.
Through desire, a man having separated himself.
A man what?
Having separated himself.
Does what?
Seeketh and intermeddleth with all wisdom.
So, when you are by yourself, you're going to find yourself studying every wind of doctrine and every false belief upon the face of the earth. And you'll never have anybody to guide you in the right direction and say, hey, bro, where you going? I've been there before. It leads to a never-ending tunnel. That is not the correct way. That's what happens when you're by yourself. From there, go to the book of Jude, chapter 1 and verse 18. I'm going to show you another reason why brothers and sisters do not congregate and why they keep to themselves. Read that.
The book of Jude, chapter 1, verse 18.
Uh-huh.
How that they told you That there should be mockers in the last time.
That there should be mockers in the last time. Read.
Who should walk after their own ungodly lusts.
Uh-huh.
These be they who separate themselves.
These be they who what?
Separate themselves.
These be they who separate themselves. Showing you what? When you are in the spirit of Christ, when you are in the spirit of the Most High God, you are trying to gather your people together. So if you have a spirit of being alone, that is not the spirit of God. Read that again.
These be they who separate themselves.
Read.
Sensual, uh-huh. Having not the spirit.
God says that you are sensual and you do not have the spirit of Christ when you roll in that spirit, when you want to keep to yourself, when you don't want to come to the Sabbath, when you don't want to come to the feast day. That's not the spirit of God. From there, Zephaniah chapter 2 and verse 1. We said it before and I'm going to say it again. This is the true spirit of Christ. Christ's whole mission was gathering the 12 tribes of Israel together, not to be apart, not to be alone, just to show you the spirit of Christ is to gather them together. When the Most High God wanted to punish us, he scattered us amongst the four corners of the earth, showing you what? This is punishment that all the 12 tribes can't be together in one land. That was a form of punishment. And when we have done our punishment, he's going to put us what? Back together. So the spirit of being in one mind and one body is the spirit of God. Understand that. Read that scripture.
Zephaniah chapter 2 verse 1.
Uh-huh.
Gather yourselves together.
Uh-huh.
Yea, gather together. O nation not desired.
You see that? The Bible is a spirit of coming together. It's not one of being an individual like or separating yourself. That's the spirit of the devil. So if you in that mindset, if you in that philosophy, that's not what the scriptures say. So, the scripture says gather yourselves together. We're going to give you two more scriptures. In the last days, Christ is going to deliver the children of Israel. And he's going to place us back into the wilderness. Those that have not learned how to love their brothers, how to not be charitable towards their brothers, they will not know how to behave when somebody tells them, hey, brother, you out of line. Or, hey, this is the correct way, that's the wrong way. If you haven't been practicing that and experiencing that, there's going to be a rude awakening when we get into the wilderness. Ezekiel chapter 20 and verse 33. This is the reason why we do it. All of this is just practice. This is a practice run for when we get into the wilderness. Read that.
Ezekiel chapter 20 verse 33.
Uh-huh.
As I live, saith the Lord God,
uh-huh.
Surely with a mighty hand and with a stretched out arm,
uh-huh.
And with fury poured out,
read.
Will I rule over you,
uh-huh.
And I will bring you out from the people, and will gather you out of the countries wherein you are scattered,
read.
With a mighty hand and with a stretched out arm,
uh-huh.
And with fury poured out,
read.
And I will bring you into the wilderness.
So, Christ is going to bring us into the wilderness, read.
Of the people, and there will I plead with you face to face.
Uh-huh.
Like as I pleaded with your fathers in the wilderness,
uh-huh.
Of the land of Egypt.
Read.
So will I plead with you, saith the Lord God.
So guess what? We are going to go back into the wilderness. And guess what's going to happen in the wilderness? Some people are going to be murmuring. Some people are going to be complaining. Some people are going to be in the midst of sin. And brothers and sisters that have learned to take correction, they're going to be able to gather themselves together. Those that are not prideful, that know how to work together, they are going to be successful when they're put in that position. That's why it says in 1 Corinthians, it says, let this be as an example unto you. Because we're going to be in that same situation. So we're going to end with this. Judges chapter 5 and verse 11. So we're exhorting you. We pray that you come together. You don't want to join Israel United in Christ, that's fine. But join a body of believers so you can get yourself built up according to the scriptures. Because God tells us to congregate. Read that.
Judges chapter 5 verse 11.
Uh-huh.
They that are delivered from the noise of archers.
Read.
And the places of drawing water.
Read.
There shall
what?
They rehearse the righteous acts.
In the lands of our captivities, we are to rehearse the righteous acts. What are the righteous acts? We read it in Leviticus 23. Those were laws that were written that we must congregate. That we must have what? Solemn assemblies. Meaning a gathered together of all those like-minded Israelites that wanted to keep the commandments of God. All right, so we pray you understood. With that, we say shalom.
Shalom.
Now you will see the true men of God. We are not black men, we are Israelites.
Take care of us.
Take care of our wives.
And their children too.
And our children too.
We have a say that I'm a Jew, it's out odd. For years I've been walking around saying that I'm a black man. I ain't saying that no more, it's out wrong, man.
This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us. Subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.